What is arthritis and osteoarthritis? Arthritis simply means joint inflammation. There are many different types of arthritis, but in this video, we're going to talk about the most common type, osteoarthritis, where osteo means bone. Osteoarthritis is a very common long-term condition, affecting hundreds of millions of people around the world. While it can happen at any age, it most commonly develops after the age of 50. In fact, many people, as they get older, will develop a degree of osteoarthritis in their joints, and around 10 to 20% will experience symptoms. It is also more common in women than men and may run in families. Other risk factors include being overweight, as this increases the load on the joints, previous joint injury, and overusing a joint, for example, due to your job. But why does osteoarthritis occur? First, let's look at a joint close up. Joints are places where two bones meet, such as the knee or elbow. In between the bones is a smooth, tough, slippery material called cartilage, which cushions the bones, and a joint capsule, which is filled with fluid. During normal daily activities, our joints undergo low levels of stress and injury, which is usually repaired. In osteoarthritis, however, the cartilage wears down over time and the joint surface becomes rougher, leading to inflammation. Bony growths can develop around the joint and extra fluid can build up, causing swelling. This leads to the main symptoms of osteoarthritis, which most commonly affect the knees, hips, hands, feet, and lower back. Joint pain and tenderness is usually worse at the end of the day or after activity. Joint stiffness usually happens after resting, but often wears off after movement. The joint may appear swollen or enlarged, or may make grating or crackling sounds. Muscle thinning and weakness can occur, and the joint may give way if it has become less stable. The severity of symptoms is different from person to person. For some, the symptoms come and go, sometimes for no obvious reason, sometimes after using the joint, or with changes in the weather. For others, the pain is more continuous and severe, making it difficult to carry out normal daily activities. Your doctor can usually diagnose osteoarthritis just by hearing about your symptoms. If they are not sure about what is causing the joint pain, they may use imaging and lab tests, such as x-rays or blood tests, to rule out other conditions, such as other types of arthritis. So how is osteoarthritis treated? While there is no cure for this long-term condition, it does not necessarily get worse over time. Don't be afraid to use the joint, as too much rest can worsen stiffness. Instead, try to keep up normal activities while taking breaks and not pushing yourself too hard. Simple pain relief, both tablets and gels, can relieve pain to help you to stay active, as can heat therapy and cold therapy. Your doctor or physiotherapist may recommend structured exercises and a weight loss plan to get you started and provide tips on good posture and leading a healthy lifestyle. Assistive devices can also be helpful, such as special footwear or insoles, walking aids and splints or braces. Occupational therapists can also help with adaptations to your home or workplace. Your healthcare team should review your symptoms over time. If these therapies haven't worked, they might suggest further treatment if appropriate. In the most severe cases, surgery can be used to repair, strengthen, fuse, or replace the joint. Living with osteoarthritis can be difficult, particularly if it impacts on work and daily activities, and it is not uncommon to feel low or depressed. As well as getting advice and regular reviews with your doctor, patient support groups are available to connect with others who are going through similar experiences. With the right support, many people with osteoarthritis can lead a healthy and active life. In this health sketch, we've talked about the common long-term condition, osteoarthritis, which leads to inflammation of the joints. We've talked about who is at risk, how it occurs, the symptoms that result, and ways of managing the condition. We hope this health sketch has been helpful for you and those around you. Health Sketch. Health for all to see.